Hermit crabs don't produce their own shells, and they'll salvage whatever they can get their claws on for protection.
So I heard about the work you're doing with the hermit crabs, which I thought perfect. It's actually a perfect fit because we're taking something that's creative.
Absolutely.
And you're working with science.
Robert has been making hermit crab shells out of blown glass for almost 20 years.
One day I was on the beach in Abaco, just off the Bahamas, and I saw something out of the corner of my eye, and it was a broken neck of a glass bottle.
Right.
And there was a hermit crab living in it.
Really?
What really got me interested is, if it can live in a glass bottle, I can certainly make a better house.
Sure.
So I started blowing, and 6 months, not one crab moved in.
No, they didn't like it? What happened? Not enough room? The rent was too high?
I don't know. I was like, what's wrong with these crabs? So I took some real shells, cut them in half, and realized that the spiral on the shell was going right-hand spiral.
Right.
All the shells I was blowing had a left-hand spiral.
Wow.
So I changed how I was blowing them and blew the spiral in the other direction.
Okay.
And boom, they moved right in.
That's so cool.
And I can puff out the shell an extra amount, and it seems that they really like the extra space that I give them.
Look at that guy. I mean, it's just an incredible little creature. I didn't realize how long their bodies
were. Look at this body wraps all the way around.
These shells not only protect the crabs, but they also make them visible for the kids to study. It's literally a window into animal behavior, anatomy, and art.
We'll start with some clear ones, and then I'm gonna have you choose some of your favorite colors.
Okay, perfect.
And we'll put them in the shell and melt it in and try to make a mobile home for a hermit crab.
Awesome.
Now it's 2,300 degrees.
That's no joke, huh?
It's pretty hot.
Wow. That's like volcano hot.
So we're gonna now gather glass onto the blowpipe.
Okay.
Just like a honeypot.
Whoa. So it's really like taffy almost. I mean, the consistency of taffy.
I have a little blowpipe here that can put air through the pipe. You can see the bubble.
Yeah, I see a bubble
expanding.
Forming.
Yeah. And we're gonna stretch it out, which is a really important step, because if the hollow space inside doesn't go all the way to the tip of the tail, if it's not long enough to really retract in, they're not gonna live in it.
Man, this is amazing.
Looks good, only the hermit crabs will let us know.
Yeah, they're the judges on this, aren't they?
I know, my critics. So now this goes into an annealing oven, and it cools down overnight, and the annealing oven's right over here.
Right. And this just, what, cools it down slowly?
This cools it down so you can knock it right off.